Right now, a sinkhole is still not repaired more than 24 hours after it opened up and swallowed one car. Now, John Gonzalez was in Bladensburg as that story unfolded yesterday morning. John, I was out there with you yesterday afternoon. What a mess. Any improvement for these families out there? Any sign of repairs to this roadway?
Well, just a little bit, Brad, but still a lot of work and cleanup left today. We can tell you that many of the basements here in Bladensburg, Maryland, remain flooded this morning. And as you can see, Edmonston Road here is still a mess of cones and asphalt. Much of this massive sinkhole has been covered up with some of this asphalt here, but you can see there's still a crater. And again, WSSC crews will be back out here. This was a 12-inch, 90-year-old water main that ruptured. Water has been restored. That's the good news. Overnight to about 77 customers. You can see that fire hydrant is running, overflowing with water, relieving some of the pressure from the job site here. But crews say it will take a couple of more days to make the repairs and reopen Edmonston Road here. And this, of course, has been a harrowing and difficult 24 hours for the families here on the block. At 3 o'clock yesterday morning, the water main broke, creating that massive sinkhole. And we've seen the images by now of that sinkhole swallowing up one car with a family of five inside, three small children. They were able to get out safely before the entire car just sunk. And then, of course, that sinkhole threatening to swallow up a second car. And we saw, as we arrived here yesterday, the families rushing and scrambling out of their homes with a few belongings and their children in hand. Some folks didn't even have time to put on their shoes. And of course, again, the work will continue throughout the day today and probably for the next couple of days. WSSC will be trucking in asphalt from out of state. That's how huge of a job this is. 375 water main leaks and breaks so far for WSSC this year. Well, this perhaps the biggest so far. Reporting live, John Gonzalez, ABC 7 News.